viewers, welcome to your own program, The Big Question. Can you visualize a classroom where the learners are asking questions and their questions are being answered? Where the learners are controlling their own learning process through technology, that is, through a click of a mouse or a remote control? Well, that is the topic for discussion today: e-learning and the role of the teacher. Some of the issues that we are going to discuss today are the role of the teacher in the changing times, the materials that are produced for the learner pedagogy, and finally, the evaluation system. We have two experts with us today. Sitting to my left is Mr. Yogendra Kumar Agarwal, who is the head of Department of Computer Sciences, Government Polytechnic College, Jodhpur. And sitting to my right-hand side is Ms. Parminder Kaur, lecturer from Institute of Engineering and Technology, Ropat. And our audience comprises of distinguished faculty members from various disciplines across the country. To initiate the discussion, Mr. Agarwal, I would like to know if a classroom minus the teacher is going to be a reality soon?
कंप्यूटर से शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में एक नया आयाम जुड़ा है और अब कंप्यूटर की सहायता से पढ़ना लिखना और सीखना समझना बहुत आसान होता जा रहा है.
What do you think about this, Ms. Parminder?
I agree with what Mr. Agarwal has just added. With the changing time, the role of the teacher is going to change. From the traditional classroom teaching, we are fast moving towards e-learning, and we have to adapt it as a society.
Now let us see what the audience have to say about this.
My question to the panel is, what about the human element in education, particularly the effective communication?
That's a good question.
ऐसा ह्यूमन एलिमेंट को कभी भी इग्नोर नहीं किया जा सकता, क्योंकि जितने भी ई कॉमर्स के सॉफ्टवेयर्स और सिस्टम्स डेवलप किए जाते हैं उसमें कहीं ना कहीं ह्यूमन इन्वॉल्वमेंट होता है. इसके अलावा भी जब भी कंप्यूटर से टीचिंग होती है या ई लर्निंग के द्वारा टीचिंग की जाती है तो उस समय कोई भी टीचर साथ में रह सकता है तो जस्ट टू प्रोवाइड ह्यूमन टच.
विल द इंस्ट्रक्शन थ्रू सैटेलाइट थ्रेटन द एम्प्लॉयमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज ऑफ द प्रोस्पेक्टिव टीचर्स?
डेफिनेटली टू सम एक्सटेंट. As the role of the teacher is going to change, if we are recording a program, it will be recorded only once and will be telecasted to over 1,000 or 100 of centers across the nation or worldwide. So at some places, the need for a teacher will be cut down, and for the uploading and downloading of these programs, we'll be having a need of more and more technicians rather than teachers.
Is it not possible to upload these programs by the teachers themselves instead of having technical staff?
We can train the teachers. There can be teamwork, but but we can't replace the technicians just by teachers. Just to prove our point that their jobs will not be cut.
I think she has a point over there. What she tries to say is that we are slowly moving towards a team learning and team teaching, where we definitely require a subject expert, that's the teacher, but we will at the same time have a lot of technical people assisting the subject expert. Any other question, please?
Whether really technology replaced the role of teacher?
Technology cannot always replace a human teacher. Technology is always to add. Technology ki sahayata se kisi bhi cheez ko seekhna samajhna zyada aasan ho sakta hai. क्योंकि जैसा कि अपन सब लोग जानते हैं कि 5 सेंसेस टेक प्लेस करते हैं लर्निंग के अंदर, और कंप्यूटर से या कंप्यूटर असिस्टेड लर्निंग जब भी की जाती है तो उसमें बोलना और सुनना और देखना, ये सारी चीज़ें संभव हो पाती हैं. और एग्जांपल्स जो रियल लाइफ में वैसे दिखाना क्लासरूम में संभव नहीं हो पाता, वो भी कंप्यूटर पर हम आसानी से दिखा सकते हैं. सो आई थिंक इट इज़ द बेटर मीडियम टू टीच फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स.
That's a very good point he has raised over there. I guess Mr. Agarwal was trying to talk about the learning styles, where some of the learners are audio, some of them are kinesthetic and some of them are visuals. And definitely a computer-assisted language learning or any other technological learning is going to help the learners in doing so. Can I invite a few more questions from the audience, please?
Yes, madam. E-learning system mein kya evolution up to the mark possible hai?
E-learning se jab bhi question answer session hota hai, to basically wo teacher se jo apan question answer session hota hai usse slightly different hota hai. Usme koi bhi lesson hota hai, computer mein koi bhi lesson pehle student apne pace se dekhta hai, apni speed se dekhta hai. उसके बाद में उसके अंदर कुछ क्वेश्चंस ऑब्जेक्टिव के फॉर्म में अवेलेबल रहते हैं, उनको स्टूडेंट अटेम्प्ट करता है विदाउट एनी हेजिटेशन, और उसके बाद में हाथों हाथ उसको अपना जो भी उसने काम किया है उसका इवेल्यूशन मिल जाता है एंड ही कैन इंप्रूव.
आई वुड लाइक टू ऐड इज व्हेन अ टीचर प्रिपेयर्स द क्वेश्चन पेपर द आंसर्स आर फेड अवे एट सम फार ऑफ प्लेस मे बी इन अ डेटाबेस सर्वर. सो इवेल्यूशन इज डन एट द सर्वर, नॉट बाय अ टीचर. सो जो अनफेयर मींस हम कहते हैं या पार्शियलिटी वाला फैक्टर है वो एलिमिनेट हो जाते हैं. अनबायस्ड इवैल्यूएशन इज पॉसिबल थ्रू ई लर्निंग.
व्हाट द एक्सपर्ट्स आर ट्राइंग टू से इज दैट द इवैल्यूएशन बिकम्स टोटली ऑब्जेक्टिव वेयर द सब्जेक्टिव एलिमेंट ऑफ द टीचर इज नलिफाइड. एनी अदर क्वेश्चन प्लीज.
माय कंसर्न इज कैन दिस टेक्नोलॉजी ई लर्निंग can meet the requirement of the rural population where the peoples are not getting power for 8 hours or 10 hours per day?
Definitely, sir. It can be done, but I agree with you. There are far off places in India where there is a shortage of teacher and the students are not getting enough resources. Infrastructure has also not been developed to provide them with quality education. We can make use of e-learning concept. At those places, we just need to have appropriate infrastructure. We can have one center, one e-learning center in every village, where the programs that are transmitted from one center, they can be received at those points. And we can make separate timetables for separate classes, for separate sections of people who require education. It will take time, but we can work harder to make it a reality, make it possible.
इसमें अपन ये भी देख सकते हैं कि जैसे आजकल किसान कॉल सेंटर हैं या ऑलरेडी ऑपरेट कर रहे हैं, और इसके अलावा इग्नू वगैरह के प्रोग्राम्स आते हैं जिससे गांव के लोग लाभान्वित होते हैं. दैट इज़ वन टाइप ऑफ ई लर्निंग कोर्स.
आई थिंक वी हैव टू लुक एट बोथ द साइड्स ऑफ द कॉइन वेयर टेक्नोलॉजी डज ब्रिंग इन इट्स ओन प्लस पॉइंट्स एट द सेम टाइम लुकिंग एट द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चरल अवेलेबिलिटी इन अ कंट्री लाइक इंडिया. We have to gear up for that as well. Could I invite a last question from the audience?
Sir, skill is required on every platform of the life. By e-learning, can we have acquisition of these different skills required on real life situations?
E-learning ke case mein, agar hamare paas mein kisi skillful टीचर की या स्किलफुल परफॉर्मर की अगर सीडी अवेलेबल है तो उससे डेफिनेटली हम काफ़ी कुछ सीख सकते हैं. और एक सबसे बड़ी बात है, जैसा कि मैंने पहले भी कहा कि दिस इज़ सेल्फ पेस्ड लर्निंग. अगर आप कोई चीज़ मिस कर जाते हैं तो आप उस सीडी को बार बार प्ले कर सकते हैं और यू कैन रियली इम्प्रूव.
इज राइट इन सेइंग दैट बिकॉज रिसर्च डज टेल अस दैट स्टूडेंट्स और लर्नर्स रिमेंबर 10% ऑफ व्हाट दे रीड, 20% ऑफ व्हाट दे सी, 50% of what they see and hear, but 90% of what they perform. So this concept of e-learning or learning through, or what we call self-based learning, is more towards learning through involving yourself into it. So to conclude the discussion, I would like to gather the views and put it together this way, that technology may not be able to replace a teacher as such totally, but if we as teachers can adapt it as an add-on to the existing tools that we have and make maximum out of this wonderful tool that has been provided to us, then I think the learners at the other end are going to be benefited by this. I take this opportunity to thank the experts and the audience who are present over here. Thank you.